So in this report, we examined trends in the reasons why parents did not vaccinate or do not intend to vaccinate. And we looked at the time period of 2010 to 2016, and we looked in both boys and girls from the United States that were in the vaccine age range. And sort of the motivation for this study was actually based on an earlier study that we had conducted together, where we were looking at subgroups of the population who did not vaccinate or did not to intend to vaccinate. And so that paper gave us a clue to who was not currently being vaccinated in the United States. And then this paper is an extension so we can understand why those individuals do not intend to vaccinate. And so in this paper, parents reported the reasons why they don't intend to vaccinate in the coming year. And that was really just because it gave us an indication of sort of where we could go next. If we now know who is not being vaccinated and why they're not being vaccinated, it could really guide our interventions, both in a public health level and a clinical level.
So in looking from 2010 to 2016, we found that for both boys and girls, common reasons that parents reported they didn't want to vaccinate their children included lack of safety, perceived lack of safety, perceived lack of necessity, and then also a lack of knowledge about the vaccine. And this really didn't change a lot over time for either gender. What we found that changed a lot was the concern about sexual activity. We saw that this concern was reported a lot less in 2016 compared to 2010 for both genders, and the concern about the child being male actually decreased all the way to 3%, so it was very low reported reason for lack of vaccination. And then when we looked at 2016 specifically and said, you know, what are the contemporary reasons that boys versus girls are not being vaccinated? Our two major findings were that for boys, the lack of recommendation was reported by 1 in 5 parents, compared to girls, where 1 in 10 reported a lack of recommendation. And then also for boys, the prevalence of reporting safety as a concern for lack of vaccination increased to about 15%.
I think what the data sort of help us do now is take a step forward as a public health body and to come up with both recommendations, or how we can better phrase recommendations geared towards our parents, but also where we can put our efforts with regards to health communication campaigns. So over the time course, right, of the last 10 years that the HPV vaccine has been FDA recommended, we see that safety remains a persistent concern among parents. And this is despite the scientific literature growing and growing with regards to data really showing safety of the current vaccine. And so knowing both what has or has not changed over time, as well as what are the concerns right now for parents in America, I think that's really where we need to sort of merge both our understanding of parents and our ability to properly communicate with those parents to create really responsive public health campaigns.
And then from a physician perspective, so physicians who are recommending the vaccine, which can include pediatricians, family practice doctors, including mid-level such as nurse practitioners, physician assistants, as well as OBGYNs. I think our data really informs them that the concern about sexuality and the need to address sexuality prior to recommending or discussing the vaccine really is a much lower priority for parents and should not serve as a barrier to recommendation. So physicians need to recognize that parents are still concerned about safety and necessity. And with extra education about the vaccine, physicians can really provide parents with that information to empower them to vaccinate their children against this incredibly important cancer preventing vaccine.
Yeah, I think this raises one really final important point. I think this is really uniting both the population that we're targeting, right, the parents of our young adolescents, with our broader public health messages. We now have nationwide commercials geared at increasing HPV vaccination and aligning those messages with the messages that they then hear from the provider. So we have a consistent message that really presents a united front towards our parents with the common goal of increasing HPV vaccination in the U.S.